Hello students, it's day one for chapter physical quantities and measurement. The objectives of this chapter are measurement of area, measurement of volume, measurement of density of regular solids and calculation of speed. The specific objectives of today's topic are measurement, that is on page number 9, and measurement of area, that is on page number 10. So our first topic for today is measurement. Before starting up with measurement, we should know what are physical quantities. Physical quantities, you have done it in 6th standard also. The quantities that can be measured are called physical quantities. Physical quantities consist of magnitude and unit. For example, 30 centimeter represents an example for length, which is a physical quantity. In 30 centimeter, 30 is magnitude and centimeter is a unit. Now next is, what is unit? A known fixed quantity which is used to measure the magnitudes of other quantities of same nature. What is same nature here? Same nature means, if I am going to measure length of a substance, I'll use the unit of length only, that is, can be meter, centimeter, decimeter, kilometer. It cannot be like liters, grams, second. It should be the unit of length only. That is why we have to write here of same nature, that is used to measure the magnitudes of other quantities of same nature. There are four system of units: SI units, CGS units, FPS units and MKS units. Next one is SI unit, that is standard international units, the units which are accepted by majority of people throughout the world. The other one is CGS, that is centimeter gram second units. Then it is FPS, which was used in ancient times, foot pound second. MKS, meter kilogram seconds. We use generally SI and CGS units in physics. Types of physical quantities. There are two types of physical quantities as done in class 6th also. Fundamental quantities, derived quantities. Fundamental quantities, the quantities which are independent quantities or which do not depend upon any other quantities are called fundamental quantities. We have discussed length, mass, time, temperature in class 6th also. Derived quantities. D for derived, D for dependent. The quantities which depend upon fundamental quantities, they are called as derived quantities. Example, area, volume, density. In physics, we have 7 fundamental quantities and we have uncountable derived quantities. The 7 fundamental quantities in physics are length, mass, time, temperature, electric current, which is there in your syllabus. Rest 2 are luminous intensity and amount of substance, which we will do in senior classes. Coming to our today's topic, that was measurement. Let's suppose I want to measure the length of this line. Length of this line is unknown to me. I don't know what is the length of this line. Length here is physical quantity. So it is an unknown physical quantity to me. I want to know its length. I'll use a scale. Yes. Now scale here will act as a known quantity. I'll keep this scale here and will measure its length. It's 6.7 centimeter. So what did I do? I compared an unknown quantity with a known fixed quantity of same nature. Of same nature means that for measuring the length of this line, I have to use a scale only. I cannot use a beam balance to measure the length of this line. So that is why I have written here of same nature. Now our next topic is measurement of area. Area is defined as the amount of surface covered by an object. That how much of surface is covered by an object, it defines its area. Now let's suppose I want to measure the area of this disc. For this, I'll make an outline of this disc on a white sheet paper. Now, I'll find the area of this circle by the formula pi r square, where r is radius of the circle. And in this way, I'll know what is the area of the disc. SI unit of area is square meter. It is denoted by small m raised to power 2. Area of regular objects. We have done it in junior classes also. Area of square is equals to side multiplied by side or side square. Area of rectangle, length into breadth. Area of circle, pi r square, where pi is 22 upon 7, or you can write it as 3.14. Then next is multiples of square meter. Multiples means bigger units. Multiples of square meter are kilometer square or hectares. Sub multiples of square meter. Sub multiples means smaller units of meter square. That is centimeter square or millimeter square, which are generally used. Now this was all about area of regular objects. Now we are going to discuss area of irregular objects. For discussing the area of irregular objects, let's perform an activity. Let's suppose I want to find the area of this leaf. This is an irregular object. For this, you can use either a graph paper or any square sheet paper whose each box is of same width. That is, the area of each square is same. I have taken this sheet whose side of each square is 1 centimeter square. For finding the area of this leaf, I'll make the outline of this leaf on this paper. Now, put the ticks on number of complete squares. As area of complete squares is given as area of one square multiplied by number of complete squares. Area of one square, as we have discussed, it was 1 centimeter square. And number of complete squares, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22 and 23. So area of complete squares come up to 1 into 23, that is 23 centimeter square. Now next is area of incomplete squares. For finding the area of incomplete squares, mark crosses on incomplete squares like this and then count that crosses 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. These are 19 in number. Now area of incomplete square is given as area of one square, that is 1 centimeter square, multiply by 19, that is number of incomplete squares. From here it comes up as 19 centimeter square. Now area of irregular objects is given as area of complete squares, which was 23, plus half of area of incomplete squares, which was 19. So here comes the answer, that is 32.5 centimeter square approx. Learning outcomes of today's topic are: what are physical quantities, what is a unit, types of physical quantities, what is measurement, measurement of area, area of regular objects and area of irregular objects.